Hi Chana, this is a question from topic kinematics in physics. I suggest this one for the students from 9th to 12th standard. You read the question. There are two cities, Vijayawada and Yeluru, connected by a straight road, National Highway number 5. Distance between these two cities is 60 km. RTC is running day and night, non-stop bus services between these two cities. The information about bus frequency is also provided in the question. For every 5 minutes, a bus departs from Vijayawada to reach Yeluru. Similarly, for every 5 minutes, a bus departs at Yeluru to reach Vijayawada. Each bus has uniform speed 60 km per hour. Now you got into a bus at Vijayawada bus terminal, sitting on right window side. You started counting the number of buses facing and crossing you until you reach the destination Yeluru. What will be your count? That is, how many buses will cross you? You have to make an assumption that there is no traffic jam, no other traffic or buses from other cities. Such kind of assumptions you have to make on your own, otherwise you can't proceed to solve. And what is travel time for any bus between these two cities? It is very simple, 1 hour. Distance is 60 km, bus speed is also 60 km per hour. So it is 1 hour travel time. There is no big deal with calculation. You can easily solve this question. Sincerely pause this video for 3 minutes and try to solve it. Okay? Then pause. Now let me guess your answers with my experience. Some of you might have got the answer 6 or one more 7 or one less 5. Most of you might have got 12 or one more 13 or one less 11. And few of you might have got 23 or 24, the correct answer. The correct answer is 23. The wrong sense behind the set of these three answers is different from the wrong sense behind the set of these three answers. Sometimes if wrong senses are cleared, then automatically it will drive us towards correct solution. Right? Say, some Ajay has got his answer is 6. And some Vijay has got 12. Then who else got this correct answer 23? Say some Vasu. Now with my experience, I am trying to guess the thought process of Ajay and Vijay. Now let me clear the wrong sense of Ajay first. This is Vijayawada, this is Yeluru. Straight road, 60 km is the distance. He reached Vijayawada bus terminal at 7 a.m. A bus is ready to depart. He got into this bus. He is thinking that at same time 7 a.m. a bus departs from Yeluru also. There is no wrong with that. These two buses will meet at middle. So he is thinking that this is first bus to cross him. From here onwards, his counting begins with 1. For first 30 minutes of his journey, no bus crossed him. For last 30 minutes of his journey, he is going this way. One bus will cross him. After 5 minutes, one more bus will cross him. After 5 minutes, one more bus will cross him. Like this. For remaining journey of 30 minutes, 30 minutes is equal to 6 into 5 minutes. So he is thinking that total number of buses facing and crossing him in opposite direction is 6. That's why he came up with this answer 6. Mr. Ajay, if really this is your sense, I consider this answer is not only a wrong one, this is a bad answer also. Array. Are you thinking no bus departed from Vijayawada or from Eluru before 7 a.m. No bus departed before 7 a.m. Oh, do you think you are a privileged passenger for RTC? As such, all the buses are waiting for your arrival. Until then, no bus departed. You got up at 6 a.m. from your bed and taking bath, doing puja, finishing all the activities. Finally, this VIP arrived at 7 a.m. to Vijayawada bus terminal. And RTC department, all the officers decided to start the buses now. Are you read the question properly? You read it properly. What is given in the question? Not only the bus is non-stop between these two cities, bus service is also non-stop. Day and night continuous bus service this is. Before 7 a.m. also buses have departed from Vijayawada as well as from Eluru. 5 minutes before your arrival, 5 minutes before your arrival, that is 6:55 a.m. One bus departed. Where is that bus? That is obviously on the way. This one. Similarly from Eluru also, 6:55 a.m. one bus departed. That is on the way, opposite way, coming this way. What about the bus departed 10 minutes before your arrival, 6:50 a.m. bus, that is ahead of this one on the road. Similarly, 6:50 a.m. bus from Eluru, that is ahead of this one. Like this, there are 11 buses are on the way to Eluru, 11 buses on the way to Vijayawada, one bus at Vijayawada bus terminal, one bus at Eluru bus terminal. Total 24 buses are there. Out of 24 buses, 22 buses are on road, 2 are at bus terminals. If you view from top, or this VIP Ajay views from a helicopter, then this is the scene at 7 a.m. Then definitely some buses will cross him in his journey of first 30 minutes also. He is missing out all of them. That's why I consider his answer is bad. Now coming to the wrong sense of Vijay. Vijay, your answer is just a wrong one. It is not that bad. If my guess about your wrong sense is true, you are not feeling as you are a privileged passenger for RTC, and so you consider the fact that the buses have already departed from Vijayawada as well as from Eluru before your arrival at 7 a.m. But why did you get the wrong answer 12? You are thinking these 11 buses which are on the way to Vijayawada and this bus which is about to depart from Eluru, only these 12 buses will cross you. If this is your sense, then I question you, did you send your dead body into the bus, keeping your soul standing beside of the road facing Eluru, that is your back on Vijayawada side, and counting the number of buses crossing you? Then I agree with your count 12. Because for any standing person, so for every 5 minutes one bus will cross. Then in total journey time 1 hour, how many buses will cross? 12 only. I agree with that. But this time you are not a standing person, you are inside a moving frame. You are in a moving bus. You might feel you are sitting, you are at rest. But you should not forget the fact your bus is moving with 60 km per hour and opposite bus is also coming with 60 km per hour. With respect to your frame, opposite bus appears to move with 120 km per hour. Then right after one bus crosses you, the next bus will take 2.5 minutes to cross your bus. If your bus is standing, the next bus will take 5 minutes obviously to cross your bus. But this time you are also going in this way. Both are approaching each other. Then for next bus, it will take 2.5 minutes only to cross your bus. That means for every 2.5 minutes, one bus will cross you. So you are going this way, one bus crossing, then again after 2.5 minutes, one more bus will cross you. After 2.5 minutes, one more bus will cross you. Then for 5 minutes, two buses will cross you. For 10 minutes, four buses will cross you. For half an hour, 12 buses will cross you. For total journey time, 1 hour, if you consider, 24 buses will cross you. But the correct answer is 23 only. You have to exclude your bus, because after 1 hour, your bus will be at destination city Yeluru bus terminal. You should not count yourself crossing you. So the final answer is 23, but you still might be in a doubt, keeping all the explanation aside, how this 23 comes. See here, your bus and this bus will meet exactly at middle after 30 minutes of your journey. By that time, this one and these 11, 12 buses must have crossed you. What about the remaining journey of 30 minutes? Is there no bus to cross you? Yes, there are. What about these 11 buses, which are already ahead of your bus and on the way to Yeluru? They will reach Yeluru before your bus and they will take U-turn and they will also cross you in opposite direction. So for remaining journey of 30 minutes, these 11 buses will also cross. Then total how many buses will cross you? 11 plus 12 is equal to 23. So 23 is the correct answer. How many buses appear here total? 24. Except your bus, all other 23 buses will have to face and cross you in opposite direction. This is what the right sense of was. Okay? For better idea, I am showing the same bus service model by using a set of toy cars. Look here, this is our bus service model. This is Vijayawada and this is Yeluru. Distance between them is 60 km. All these buses are moving with uniform speed 60 km per hour. So travel time of each bus is 1 hour from here to there or from there to here. Now you got into this bus at 7 a.m. and this bus departed from Vijayawada at 6:55 a.m. That is 5 minutes before your bus. Now is on the way to Yeluru. This bus 10 minutes before departed from Vijayawada and is on the way to Yeluru. And so on, this bus 55 minutes before departed from Vijayawada and is almost about to reach the destination city Yeluru. And this bus exactly 1 hour before, that is at 6 a.m. departed from Vijayawada and is now ready to depart from Yeluru. Similarly, these 11 buses also. Now you got into this bus and started counting the number of buses crossing you in opposite direction until you reach the destination city Yeluru. You just think about first 30 minutes of your journey. After 30 minutes, your bus will reach middle of the two cities. Similarly, this bus will also reach middle of the two cities. That means this bus will cross you after 30 minutes. Before this bus, all these 11 buses must have crossed. That means in first 30 minutes of your journey, this one plus this 11 buses, total 12 buses will cross you. And for next 30 minutes of your journey, these 11 buses will also cross. How do they cross? These are already ahead of your bus. They will reach the destination city before your bus and will take U-turn and will definitely cross your bus before you reach Yeluru. So in first 30 minutes of your journey, these 12 buses, including this 7 a.m. bus at Yeluru, these 12 buses will cross you. In next 30 minutes of your journey, these 11 buses will also cross you, and so total number of buses cross you is 23. How many buses are there here on the sheet? Total 24. So these 22 buses are on road, these 2 are at terminals, except your bus. You will have to face all other 23 buses. Similarly, if another person gets into this bus, if he counts, then in the same manner, he will have to face all other 23 buses before he reaches to Vijayawada. So RTC has to maintain total 24 buses on the line to meet the conditions given in the question. This is a day and night cyclic process. Don't get silly doubts. What if fuel gets emptied for a bus? It is obviously replaced with another bus. And don't take any waiting time for any bus at the time of departure at Vijayawada or at Yeluru. So 23 is the right answer for this question. I hope you could understand this explanation. This question can improve and test your logical skills. Okay? See you again.